What's up YouTube? So today I'm going to be getting rid of my tiny TD04 Turbo and replacing it with a VF48. It's not a huge upgrade, but you should see a pretty good difference. So let's get to it. Alright guys, so the first thing I'm going to do to uninstall this old turbo is take off the intercooler. You'll disconnect this line from the intercooler. Try not to drop this bolt into the engine. I'm just going to go ahead and put this bolt back in the hole. That way I don't lose it. And then you're going to disconnect this line on this side. Give you a little bit more room to work with. And you can disconnect both these. Go ahead and pull this off. Next thing you're going to do is remove your blow-off valve or recirculating valve. Those are two 12 millimeter bolts. Alright, so once you have your bolts out, you don't really have to take this all the way off. You can just leave it on the side here. Alright, then you'll just undo these clamps for this coupler so you can slide the intercooler off. And lastly, you'll do these two bolts on each side of the intercooler. Now you should be able to pull the intercooler off. Oh, forgot one part. You gotta undo this tube down here before it'll come off. Now that that clamp is loosened, this tube should slide off the turbo. Takes a little bit of wiggling to get this guy off. There's the first part down. You got the intercooler off. So the next step is to take off the downpipe. You're going to start with these two bolts in the back here. Alright, there's also a bolt like right there for the bracket for the downpipe. So don't forget to take that one off. They're all 14 millimeters. So there's gonna be five bolts on the downpipe that you're gonna have to take off. So once you get those off, then you can take the three bolts on the up pipe off. First two you can get off without taking the downpipe off, but the last one you have to have the downpipe off to get off. You're gonna be taking five bolts off the downpipe connecting to the turbo. You're gonna need a deep socket for these probably. There's three here and two underneath. These ones can be a little tricky. I had a little rough time doing this one. It got kind of stripped, but I got it off with some vice grips and a wrench. But after you get off these five, then you should be able to pull the down pipe out, and then you'll have to unbolt the three bolts on the up pipe. So now I got the down pipe out. I'm gonna start on this up pipe. So now that I got the up pipe off, I'm gonna start disconnecting all the hoses. We got this hose on the wastegate. This one on the turbo. We got a banjo bolt here, that's the oil line. And then we got the coolant lines right here. And then there's one more line right underneath the turbo that we'll get access to when we start pulling the turbo out. Then next you'll take off the intake tube, then you should be able to get the turbo off after that. So with some wiggling and working, I finally got the turbo out. As you can see, this little port right here, that hose is connected to the bottom of the turbo, so. And it's just a little finger clamp that's on there, so you'll just disconnect it from the bottom. And then I disconnected that hose and left the top part connected to the turbo, and then disconnected this hose. And then when you're unbolting this oil line, make sure you get the bolt that's connecting this little bracket. That'll keep you from pulling it out. And then you also have to unbolt this clamp to get the air hose off of there. So we got my old TD04 and the VF48 right next to it. As you can see, mine came with the coolant lines, so if yours didn't, you'll have to take these off and put them on here. And other than that, it should be just a straight bolt up setup. So I got all the hoses switched over. Now I'm gonna replace the downpipe gasket. As you can see, this one had a leak in it, so I was probably losing some boost on that. We got this brand new Grimspeed one that I did the review on, so we're gonna put that on and then start putting the turbo back in. One tip I have for installing the turbo back in is not to bolt the downpipe or the up pipe in before you get this oil line on. It's pretty hard to get it lined up when you do, so I'm gonna have to take this pipe off and take one bolt out for the up pipe, because you can't reach this bolt without the downpipe off. So after I I take that on, I'm gonna put this oil line back on, and then she should be pretty much ready to go back together. A couple things about the install of the turbo. For one thing, the major thing that happens is make sure that the oil return line is connected. When I was messing around with some stuff, it got disconnected, so when I started my car, of course, it ended up with oil all over the garage floor. Luckily, I noticed in time, so that's another tip, is to get out and check and make sure there are no fluids leaking. After you start the car, if there is, turn it off right away, track down that leak and fix it. Another thing is that the oil return line is gonna be a little bit tricky to get back in. Don't be afraid to bend it a little bit, but don't go crazy bending it, cause then you'll snap it. Then you'll have to do a whole bunch of work to get a new one installed, and that's just something you don't wanna do. So you can bend it to get it into a good place to put the banjo bolt back in, but don't go crazy with it. Also, don't forget the copper washers. People do that a lot, and there's leaks and all kinds of stuff. So I'm gonna get this thing tuned, and we'll see what kind of power it could put down. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. I'm gonna be doing a lot more videos, trying to build up my channel, and your support means a lot to me. Thank you.